Hello, this is Wendy Zika from SAS, and today I'm going to be talking to you about automation in SAS visual data mining and machine learning. According to Forbes, one of the top artificial intelligence trends to watch out for in 2019 was the rise of AutoML, short for automated machine learning. So what is automated machine learning? It involves, as you would guess, automating the tasks that are required for building a predictive model based on machine learning algorithms. These tasks include data cleansing and preprocessing, feature engineering and selection, model selection, and hyperparameter tuning. With so many possible combinations of features, models, and hyperparameters to try, it can be very tedious to perform this all manually, just by trial and error. So there are now platforms that provide this AutoML capability that can empower data analysts or citizen data scientists by giving them a start at a machine learning workflow, as well as enable advanced data scientists to spend more time on solutions to a problem rather than being bogged down with these repetitive tasks. But the intention is not for AutoML to replace the work of data scientists, because there can be a need for things like domain-specific feature engineering to be performed by data science experts. So ideally, these systems should allow for manual intervention. These systems also need to expose the algorithms being used under the covers and not be black boxes, so that users can be aware of and understand, and thus trust, the models being generated. As you might expect, this is not new territory for SAS software. SAS Rapid Predictive Modeler was first released in 2010, giving users process flows of automated data preparation and data mining tasks as part of SAS Enterprise Miner to create predictive models. In 2017, the Model Studio Visual Interface for SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning was released, which is a modernized version of SAS Enterprise Miner that is on SAS VIA. It leverages the cloud-enabled, distributed, in-memory analytics engine of Cloud Analytics Services, or CAS. Like Enterprise Miner, Model Studio is an interactive pipeline environment for putting together the various steps for data mining and machine learning models, from data preparation to model comparison, and includes automation at various levels of the model building process. And just last year, in 2019, the 8.5 release of SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning included true AutoML, including automation of the entire machine learning pipeline, as well as other new tools for automation specific to particular tasks. So this talk will be focusing on the tools for AutoML that are new in this latest release. In Model Studio, there are two new nodes for automation, one for feature engineering and one for model algorithm selection and hyperparameter tuning, as well as the ability to have an entire machine learning pipeline generated dynamically for your specific data. This AutoML can be accessed through Model Studio if you want to use a visual interface, and also via a REST API that comes with SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning for you to embed into your own applications. So I'll talk about both of these ways to access machine learning automation and SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning, starting with using the user interface Model Studio. In the latest release of Model Studio, we have some automation enhancements in the areas of data preprocessing and feature engineering, modeling, and full pipeline automation. For data preprocessing and feature engineering, some automation that has been in all releases of Model Studio includes the data advisor that determines if columns of your data are inputs, IDs, or variables to be excluded from your model, and if they should be treated as categorical or continuous. For transforming your variables, instead of picking a single transformation to apply to all your inputs, you could use the best transformation method in the transformations node to automatically determine for you what function, if any, from a suite of functions, including log, square, inverse, etc., is the best for each individual input based on the criterion of your choosing. You can find more information about these two features in our paper, but today I'm going to focus on the feature machine node, our new automated feature engineering node that came out in 8.5 that you can think of as an extra strength version of the best transformation. In addition to the numeric transformations that are performed for the best transformation, this new feature machine node can first screen out uninformative inputs, perform multiple sets of transformations that can include imputation to create new features from each input, and extends the numeric transformations that are performed by the best transformation to include conversions such as binning to transform an interval input into a class input, encoding to transform class inputs into interval inputs, and again, based on a criterion, it will rank the new features created by these sets of transformations and return one or more features per input as specified by you, the user. You have control over the data issues that you want to address with feature engineering, shown here, so from things like missingness to outliers to high cardinality. What you select dictates which transformations are applied to inputs that exhibit various levels of these data issues. Here you can see the feature machine node in a Model Studio pipeline with its properties displayed on the right. And here you see a table included in the results of the node, showing for the variable age, the various features that were created using a set of transformations such as medium-based imputation followed by squaring or logging the values, tree-based binning, and others, along with their rank according to the symmetric uncertainty coefficient that can simultaneously rank interval and nominal features with respect to your target. Now let's talk about modeling. Since its first release, Model Studio has had automatic hyperparameter tuning, or auto-tuning, available in many of its supervised learning nodes for training a predictive model. Hyperparameters are properties that affect the training process, such as learning rate, regularization parameters, and the number of trees for a forest model. Finding the optimal value for the hyperparameters for each model can involve a lot of manual trial and error. To find them in an automated manner, auto-tuning searches the hyperparameter space to determine the values that optimize the selected objective function, typically a measure of model error like misclassification rate, using search methods such as Bayesian kriging, genetic algorithm, grid search, Latin hypercube sampling, or random search. This model is then trained with these hyperparameter values. The Model Composer node takes this to another level, an extra strength version of single model auto-tuning. In this new supervised learning node in Model Studio, you can auto-tune various model types in parallel and perform multiple rounds of auto-tuning. This means after the first round where auto-tuning evaluations are equally allocated, subsequent rounds allocate more evaluations to the best performing model type. At the end of the rounds, the overall best model for your data and its optimal set of hyperparameters, also specific to your data, are used for training. So model selection is intrinsically and automatically performed for you as well. Here are the properties available to you in the Model Composer node. You can choose which model types you want to include in the auto-tuning, the number of rounds, and evaluations per round, which then get distributed among the model types. Then the auto-tuning properties that are available when you auto-tune a single model can also be specified here, including search method, objective function, and so on. In the results, there are several summary tables, including the hyperparameters for the best overall model. So here you see the values for things like learning and sampling rate, lasso and ridge, and tree depth for the gradient boosting model that performs the best of all modeling types for this particular data. Other tables show the fit statistics for the top model of each type, number of evaluations per model per round, and more information. Next, we're going to talk about complete pipeline automation, true AutoML. Similar to Rapid Predictive Modeler for SAS Enterprise Miner that I mentioned in the beginning, Model Studio offers a library of templates that you can use that contain static pipelines to help you get started, from basic to advanced pipelines for building a predictive model. And again, please see our paper for more information on these various templates that Model Studio provides. But new in SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning 8.5 was an option to automatically and intelligently generate a pipeline that is optimized specifically for your data and built in a dynamic fashion. This is using the REST API under the covers that I will be talking about more shortly. So now in Model Studio, when adding a new pipeline to your project, you can select this option to kick off this process that takes the static templates a step further. It attempts various data preprocessing, feature engineering and selection, and different model types, including ensembles of models, to find the optimal pipeline. A pipeline with the top five branches that lead up to a supervised learning node is generated for you, like the one shown here. The nodes that the pipeline includes and the properties that are set for them provide details of all the steps that are performed and the supervised learning algorithms that are being used. It is in no way a black box. You can optionally unlock the pipeline so you can edit it to include your domain knowledge by adding, deleting, or modifying nodes in the pipeline. Alternatively, you can run the pipeline as is to get the overall pipeline champion model based completely on automation, as shown here in the model comparison node. Here, the forest model in the branch of the pipeline that included two sets of transformations has the best KS statistic, the chosen model selection criterion, so it's designated as the champion model for this pipeline. Now we're going to talk about a different way that this automation can be accessed in SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning using the REST API for machine learning pipeline automation. This API, or Application Programming Interface, enables you to embed the automatic generation of Model Studio machine learning pipelines into your own custom applications using the language of your choice, Python, JavaScript, curl, etc. The Machine Learning Pipeline Automation REST API is a set of endpoints that automates the training of predictive models and that gives you control over various parameters such as Model Studio project settings and more. Complete documentation of the API can be found at developer.sas.com. A request to create a project requires just the input data and a target variable in order to start the pipeline automation process. Then various endpoints are available to you with the following request methods. You can use the getRequest method to return an automation project, return a list of all automation projects, get champion model information for a project, get the current state of a project, or get a list of all currently usable links. You can use a post method to create an automation project or score new data with the champion model from an automation project. Put methods can be used to update an automation project, retrain the project, and register or publish the champion model to an available destination. And delete can be used, of course, to delete an automation project. You can find an end-to-end example in Python to automatically generate pipelines using this REST API in the example1.py file in the SAS via DMML Pipelines GitHub repository for SAS software. As I mentioned, other languages or REST clients can also be used in place of Python. In the example code, there is setup for the parameters, then the code includes the request methods to carry out the following steps. First, it creates a Model Studio project for the automated pipeline. Next, it polls every 5 seconds to wait until the project state goes to completion. The project state initially starts in the pending state, and then it transitions to waiting, ready, modeling, constructing pipeline, running pipeline, and finally to the completed state. Once it's in that state, the next step is to retrieve and print the champion model information, including assessment statistics. Next, it publishes the champion model to the SAS Microanalytics Service, one of the destinations available for publishing. The fifth step is to score new data using the champion model. And finally, there's the step to retrain the project once new training data becomes available to you. Here's just a snippet of the Python code to give you an idea of how these requests are made. So just to summarize, today I covered how AutoML and SAS can be used to streamline your model building process using either the Model Studio interface or REST API for automation, both available in SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning. Please find our paper online in the conference proceedings once that is available for more detail on this, including links to code, or feel free to email me with any questions. Thank you.